Hey guys, I hope you all are doing good. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about how to get registered as an architect in Canada. So this video will be a really interesting and really, really important video for all of us who are watching this video. So try watching this video till the end. And guys, for the people who are here on my channel for the first time, my name is Saran Singh and I'm an architect by profession. I keep making such videos on a regular basis. So feel free to check out my other playlist also. And guys, without any delays, let's get started with the video. So guys, there are total three methods to get yourself registered as an architect in Canada. The first method is fairly simple and all of us know about it. That is doing your Master's of Architecture from Canada, and the master's course should be accredited by the CACB, that is Canadian Architecture Certification Board. And then you will be, after completing this course, you will be eligible to give the exam that your province or your state requires to give you. So every province and every state has their own exams and own terms and conditions to get registered as an architect. Like in Ontario, you will have to give EXAC exam for your accreditation or getting yourself registered as an architect after completing your Master's of Architecture. So this is the first method. This is fairly simple. Just do your master's, get your certificate, and then go for the exam and get yourself registered as an architect. But the second method is a bit complex, but most of the people that are here, most of the architects that are here who are not doing their master's can go for this method. And especially like the people like us, like who are doing their certification course or diploma course over here, have to go for this method of registration. So the second method of registration is going on CACB website for academic registration. Just type CACB academic registration and then you can go ahead and get your degree certified. So guys, the first thing you have to do is type CACB academic certification and click on it. Once the site opens up, if you want, you can read everything. Everything is important over here. But go on this degree/diploma not accredited by CACB. Then you will see what all universities have accreditation in Canada. So if you have done your degrees from this, you don't have to again go for it. Then other thing is like online application, what all things you will require. So just read and go through all these things. You will need your transcripts, you will need your years of studies, you will need your program, name of the program and everything. Then course name and course number or code, then length of the academic semester in terms of week. So all these things you have to mention it. So all these things you will find in the official course calendar/syllabus from the university, including the descriptions of the course, and then total the number of hours also they will be mentioned. So you have to go to your university website and search for all these things for the course syllabus and the course hours. So all these things are very important. So please read all the information very carefully. So you can even include your portfolio in it. Like all these are all the description for the portfolio. It should just have 4 pages and the size and everything. And then include all these things and pay the application fee. So that's how you will go ahead. And just if you want to know all about the application and registration process, just go on the bottom of the page and then you will find foreign programs non-US. Click on them. So once you click, you will find a PDF. You can download it from here and then just go through the entire PDF, read it very carefully. Guys, it's a lot of money. Like you will be investing around $1,800 to get yourself registered and to get your degree registered, not yourself registered. The examination fees is something different, but this is the first process and this will require $1,800. So be prepared for the payment of the fees and everything, but these information is very important. I won't be going through all of it. You can go through it on yourself. So this is it. Once your degree is certified by CACB, The next step will be you start working as an intern architect. So once you start working as intern architect, you will have to complete 3,720 hours and maintain a logbook that will prove that you have completed these many hours. And after that, you will be eligible to give the exam, that is EXAC exam. Once you give that exam and you clear that exam, you can call yourself as a registered architect. And guys, there is also a third method to get yourself registered, and this is for all the architects that are senior to us and who have at least 7 years of experience in working in architecture field in India or anywhere around the world. So this is BEFA program. So this is for broadly experienced architects all around the world who are here in Canada, who are coming to Canada. They can register for this. So what you all have to show is your degree, second, your architecture license, third, your experience, all the experience certificates and everything you have to show. And then you have to pay a fees, and fees is around $2,000. I'm not sure about it, but I will display the correct information on the screen. And guys, and one more thing that you have to have is like just work here for 6 months and then just give the certificate of experience while applying for this. I am mentioning all the details and description on the screen right now, and guys, every detail and every link is there in the description also. So if you guys have any kinds of doubts or any kinds of queries, you can go ahead, mention it in the comment section. Even I will be going for the registration process that I have showed in step number 2, but not right now. I'm just waiting to complete my entire green architecture program. I will get registered as lead, and then after that I will get registered as an architect and certify my degree and everything, because it involves money and it involves time. Right now I don't have money and I still don't have time. So anyways guys, one more very important thing, I would like to thank all of you for all your immense support. The time I'm shooting this video, our subscriber list is 9,970 subscribers, but I hope till the point I upload this video, we will be 10,000. So guys, again, I would like to thank all of you for all your support, and keep supporting ArchiVlog. I will keep making such informative videos for all of you, and let's make this community bigger. And let's expand. Be safe, take care of yourself, and guys, see you soon. Bye-bye.